If you're going to defibrillate your mannequin during the course of the scenario, you'll need the ShockLink system with the contents from this box. Included in the box is a ShockLink system, training pads, the remote, which you don't need to use, and an additional spot or in this box may be the adapter if you're using the life pack or Zoll defibrillator monitors. The default connection point is for a Philips. Make sure that your mannequin and SIM pad are connected together with the icon indicating that they're both receiving the signal. At this point, we're going to turn on the ShockLink system by opening the door and then closing again. Power button's being indicated. It's looking for the for the training pads attached. We're going to come over to the mannequin. You can store this in your defibrillator or AED. I'd recommend having it attached to the pads, even though it's not very realistic. It just saves time on confusion with the system. Placing the pads on as shown on the diagram, as you normally would. There's a small indentation where the pads should go. Again, it's normally where they would go. Turning on your AED.
Stay clear of patient. Analyzing heart rhythm. Stay clear of patient. Analyzing heart rhythm. No shock advised. Be sure emergency medical services have been called. It is safe to touch the patient.
For a non-shockable rhythm, if you do see this on your display, it is okay to update this. Do not update any other software, but if ShockLink says to update, you can update that. Just by pressing OK. It'll take probably about 60 seconds to do that, so make sure that you are ensuring the software is up to date, matching the software on the mannequin and SIM pad before you start.